Now, an E-Team exclusive.
Abandoned homes are boarded up and condemned, but still standing. And we've been telling you about the dangers these homes create for neighborhoods all over the city in our series, Cleveland Abandoned. Recently, we've followed properties owned by one corporation as the city condemned them. The owner seems to have stopped keeping them up. The E-Team's Kevin Berry explains why fixing the buildings or knocking them down could still be weeks away.
While Rob Moon mows the grass, it's in the shadow of an eyesore that records show is owned by Dentino Enterprises.
Basically, nobody was doing nothing about it.
Since we started reporting on the squatters who lived inside, the city has condemned the whole building. That means the building could be knocked down eventually. But Cuyahoga County Land Bank Chief Operating Officer Bill Whitney says it'll take roughly $13,000 after waiting for the legal system.
But it still could take 6 months to a year.
Some property owners rack up big bills just by themselves. The land bank has a list of 15 properties owned by Dentino Enterprises or the person who started that company, David Danzik. Many have been foreclosed on or sold at auction, but some are still owned by the company, like the house that just got condemned down the block from Rob.
And I don't know these individuals, so I hesitate to say anything, but I mean, I think you can see for yourself.
The land bank took this property and demolished the home that used to sit on it years after David Danzik owned it. It's part of the 4,000 properties they spend $2 million every year to maintain just until a buyer comes along. Rob says he thinks there are enough vacant lots around the city and there doesn't need to be another one on Dearborn.
As a homeowner, he should take responsibility to check on his home instead of just abandoning it like that, you know.
In Cleveland, I'm Kevin Barry for the E-Team.